When you leave the DLC, walk around the weathered steel rotunda.
It's designed to look like a Native American kiva, a traditional grain storage structure. The solid wall blocks winter winds and offers a nice shaded area for a picnic lunch. In the courtyard plaza below, your students can see a ground map that identifies cities, states, and bodies of water like the Great Salt Lake and the Colorado River.
Before you head into the NV Energy Foundation Sustainability Gallery, please note the location of the restrooms and the elevators.
Stop here and look up to see the plants growing on the structure. In time, the plants will entirely cover the area. The plants keep temperatures down by as much as 10 degrees and provide natural air conditioning. Transpiration coming from the plant's leaves also gives off a notable amount of humidity, which makes you feel cooler. This is a good example of transpiration in action.
You can also show your students an example of caliche, a limestone formation similar to concrete. We have no use for it in gardening, but the Springs Preserve repurposed caliche by creating this seating structure. One of the major causes of indoor air pollution is the stuff you track in. Wipe your shoes on this recycled tire mat before heading into the sustainability gallery. Now let's go inside.
Children love the garbage truck, which doubles as a theater. Please don't let your students climb on the truck. It's a safety hazard. This section explains food miles, the process of growing, packaging, and transporting food. Your students will learn how far food travels to their local grocery store. The water fountain model demonstrates how water is pumped from Lake Mead, our primary source of drinking water.
The home in the gallery is a prime example of green living. Point out the rammed earth walls. The natural sediment in the material is so thick, heat cannot penetrate in the summer, nor escape in the winter.
Rammed earth is similar to adobe. Springs Preserve was the first in the area to develop and use rammed earth in its LEED designed facilities, and actually helped Clark County write the building codes for its use and development. Cork and bamboo floor examples can be seen here and are much more sustainable than traditional hardwood. You can also see how straw is a good home insulator. The straw is packed so tightly there is not enough oxygen to start a fire and is encased in concrete to keep out any pests. The last section in the sustainability gallery is a good spot to talk about water use and conservation. The bathroom display is a visual way to show your students how much water they use to take a 5-minute shower, which may surprise them. There's a lot to see in the sustainability gallery. Your Teach the Teacher website has downloadable resources to help your students get the most out of the exhibit.